Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Dr. Valentino Parravicini from Oxford Cannabinoid Technologies. Valentino, fantastic to have you on the line.
No, thank you, Thomas. I'm really happy to be here again to talk about our company and our news about our project.
Fantastic. Before you get us up to speed on the news about your new trial that's being planned, could you just remind us what it is that the company actually does?
Yes, Oxford Cannabinoid Technologies, or OCT for short, is a company that is focusing on developing cannabinoids for the pharmaceutical routes. So basically, we want to take small molecule, not cannabis, at least not at the moment, but we're working on small molecules, the active ingredients into cannabis and derivatives to bring them to the patient and make sure that all the benefit that the plant seems to have, obviously, for thousands of years of popular medicine, are actually brought in a scientific way, through a scientific path to the patient, meaning going from really hardcore R&D development through the development, the preclinical development, showing safety, showing that the company is working, but is also safe, and then going to the regulator and show that the work that we prepared is actually proper to go into clinical trial. And of course, clinical trial first in healthy volunteers to show safety, and then potentially in patient to start looking at the real benefit of it. The company has four programs ongoing in different areas, although we focus in as an indications or therapeutic areas, it goes in different indication of pain. The input is different. We have synthetic molecule, completely synthetic molecule, like the one we're going to talk about a bit later. They act like a cannabinoid, but they're not a cannabinoid per se. We have phytocannabinoids. That's part of program two. So actually compounds are present in the plant, but we synthesize artificially. And then we try to develop that as a normal, if you want, a drug, rather than as a plant, as a botanical development. And then we have what we call phytocannabinoid derivatives. They are phytocannabinoids. They look like phytocannabinoids, but they're justly modified to make them better drugs, so to speak. So they behave better when they're going into our body. And again, the aim is to go through the regulatory path so that the compounds, the molecule, the drugs can be approved by the regulator and therefore prescribed by the medical doctor and reimbursed by the agency, be it the NICE, so public agencies, but also private insurances, for example.
Fantastic. And you've got a new clinical trial starting early next year. What is the focus of it and how's progress?
Yes, the progress is very good. If you want to be technical, the name of the company is OCT-421-201, with some to referring to 201 or program one. This is a small molecule, as meaning it's a single compound. And as I mentioned before, it binds the endocannabinoid receptor, that is the type of the system, the biological system in our body that recognize the element present in cannabis, but it's not a cannabinoid per se. And what it does is bind a specific receptor is called CB2. This is the one that is not associated, for example, with the psychotropic effect of THC1. So we will have potentially benefit without the drawback of a, for example, cannabis or THC. What we want to address here is pain. Again, we're not talking about pain that is treatable with over-the-counter, but actually with serious pain. And particularly, we are approaching two indications. One is chemotherapy-induced peripheral neuralgia that is caused by patient taking chemotherapeutic agents. And the other one is called irritable bowel syndrome. There is visceral pain rather than being neuropathic pain. So we are at the end of our development. We have very good results. We, in fact, obtained even today confirmation that the company is well tolerated in animals, so showing that it's safe to use. And we are basically finalizing all the documentation to submit and then to the regulatory agency, in this case, the MHRA, as a start, and then starting our clinical trial next year, Q1 2023.
Great. So could you just try to summarize for people who might not necessarily be quite so expert as yourself on these subjects, what is the potential best case scenario from this study?
Yes, this is a study that is measuring two aspects. The main one is obviously safety. That's what's called the primary objective. We want to show that our compound, like you said, to show that it's not only safe in animal, we had to test in animal, of course, but is also sort of safe in human. So we're going to test different dosing. It's called dose escalation, so going up and show that if every dose, the healthy volunteer in this case, so they're not patient, will do not react badly, effectively, to the compound, and therefore the compound is safe. Another important information we will gather is how what we call pharmacokinetic. I know it's technical, but it's basically just to give an idea how the compound behaves in our body, where does it go, and how high goes into once into the bloodstream, because the concentration in the bloodstream is always associated potentially with the efficacy. So by measuring how the compound behave, we'll have a better understanding on how to choose the dose that then will go into actually the patient. And again, will be also a further information to support the safety data.
That's great, Valentino. Now, earlier in the year, the company had to take certain steps to extend its cash runway. So how pleased is the company now that it's able to push on and make a whole new study?
It is very positive for us. That decision was not based on science or anything. Of course, completely strategic, and we had to take it. But these allow us again to enter also into this study with the confidence that we will be able to proceed after the result come out. And to starting basically preparing for the second phase that, as I mentioned, would be actually to go into the patient, what you call a phase two trial. So this was all for good. And fortunately, or thanks to the work of our collaborator, they're all working hard. As I said, the scientific outcome of our research is very good. The safety outcome are very good. So we're really looking forward to the next step.
Lovely stuff. Well, thank you very much for joining me on Proactive, Dr. Valentino Parravicini.
No, thank you again. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. It's been a pleasure.